Good morning, friends. Today we start with our online lectures. Since it has become a little difficult to go on with the offline lectures because of the pandemic, but we will take our time, revise what we have done before, and continue with our lectures. So the chapter we were on to was chapter number 11, mensuration. So a little bit of revision on this chapter. We started with three-dimensional objects, which we see in our everyday life, the cuboid, the cube, the cone, the cylinder, and the sphere. Now, these objects occupy space, so they have a volume. They are also surrounded by surfaces. They are covered by surfaces, so we try to find out the area of these surfaces. A little bit of revision what we did before, the areas that we have found out so far. So in the initial classes we studied the area of the rectangle. Now the area of the rectangle whose length is b and width is a is given by a into b. So rectangle is given by the formula a into b. Then we have the square with side A. The area of the square with side A is A into A, or we also write A square. Sometimes we also use S square when we take the side of the square to be S. Then we have the triangle. The triangle has got a base, and from the opposite vertex we draw the altitude which is perpendicular at 90 degree. The base we refer to as B and the altitude as H, and the formula of the area of triangle is given by half B into H. Next we have a parallelogram whose base is B and again the altitude drawn from the opposite vertex is H. So we have the area of the parallelogram to be b into h. You can also note that the diagonal of the parallelogram divides the parallelogram into two equal triangles. One is this triangle and one is this triangle. So since the area of the whole parallelogram is base into altitude, the triangle being half of it, the area of the triangle is half of base into altitude. Now these figures which we refer to as polygons. Why we refer to these figures as polygons is because they are closed figures made up of straight lines. But then we have the circle which is curved in nature. It has got a curved surface. And the curved surface, so we have got a center of the circle, and every point on the circle is at a fixed distance. We call the radius r. In the book it is denoted by the letter b. We usually refer it to by the letter r. And the area of the circle is given by pi r square. So we write it as pi r square. But since we have indicated the radius as b, the book has shown it as pi b square. Now remember, the pi is always involved to find surfaces, circumference, volumes of curved figures. Of curved circular figures, wherever curved surfaces are involved, we use the pi. And we have done in the previous class, pi is the ratio of the circumference to the diameter. We have to take it usually as 22/7, but when prescribed, we take it as 3.14. So depending upon the sum and the value of pi to be taken, we use it to get our answer. Now this was done in the previous classes. In this chapter, we shall see the following. The area of a general quadrilateral. Now there is no specific formula for the general area of a general quadrilateral. So first let us name the quadrilateral. Let me call it A, B, C and D. So we have got a quadrilateral A, B, C, D. There is no specific formula to find the area of the general quadrilateral. So for a convenience, what we have done, we have drawn a diagonal BD. So we can draw the diagonal BD, we can even draw the diagonal AC, or the measure of which will be given to us. So we will draw either diagram BD or AC, the diagonals. And how do you draw the diagonals? I hope you remember. The diagonals are always drawn from one vertex to the opposite vertex. So in the quadrilateral ABCD, the diagonals are AC and BD. So the measure of one of the diagonals may be given to us. So we draw the diagonal. And now we draw an altitude AM, that is perpendicular to BD. So ADB forms a triangle. If you see, we have got triangle ADB, that is this triangle. And we also draw, let me call it AM. So this triangle ADB, the area of triangle ADB, which formula do I use? Half base into altitude. So here BD shall be the base and AM shall be the altitude. AM shall be the altitude. So the area of triangle AD will be half into the base BD into the altitude AM. Then we draw another altitude from C to BD and call it CN. So now we find the area of this triangle, that is area of triangle CDB, CDB, area of triangle CDB, that is again half into base into altitude. So here this BD is our base again, so we keep it as it is, BD into CN, which is our altitude. So now we have area of the quadrilateral ABCD. So if I want to find the total area of this quadrilateral, what I do, I add this triangle and I add this triangle. So that is area of triangle ADB plus area of triangle CDB. So we have half into BD into AM plus half into BD into CN. And if we take the half and BD common, so half into BD is taken common, we are left with AM plus CN. So here we have given you the formula, but you have to just see, to find the area of a general quadrilateral, we divide the quadrilateral into two triangles. Okay, so what we do for convenience, we divide the quadrilateral into two triangles, ADB and CDB, and then separately we find the area of both the triangles, add them together, and that is how we get the area of the general quadrilateral. So I hope you have followed this. If you haven't, then kindly rewind the video and see it one more time. This is a general quadrilateral. Since there is no formula, direct formula to find the area of a general quadrilateral, we have divided into two triangles. Triangle ABB, that is one triangle, and triangle CDB, the second triangle. Then adding both the triangles together, I get the area of the whole quadrilateral. Now why I have done this? I have done this because I know the formula of the area of the triangle. Now if we try out one sum, we will understand in much detail. So let us find out the area of the quadrilateral P Q R S. Okay, now one diagonal is given as 5.5, so we can see the diagonal is QS. So we'll write QS is equal to 5.5 centimeter. One height is 2.5 centimeter, so the bigger height RN, this is the bigger height, this is 2.5 centimeter, and the smaller height PM is 1.5 centimeter. So SQ is 5.5 centimeter, QS we have PM equal to 1.5 centimeter, and we have RN equal to 2.5 centimeter. So area of quadrilateral PQRS is the area of two triangles separately. So you can even find the area by finding the two triangles separately, or the formula which you derived in the previous slide, that is half into diagonal, that is QS, into the sum of the two altitudes, that is PM plus RN. So what is this again? This is a diagonal which we have. The diagonal, we add to it height 1 and height 2, or we could just say it to be half into D, the diagonal, into the height H1 plus H2. Now all you have to do is replace the values. So half into 5.5 into PM, that is 1.5, plus RN, that is 2.5. So we have half into 5.5 into 1.5 plus 2.5 is 4. So we now can cut to 1za, to 2za. We are left with 5.5 into 2, that is 11 centimeter square. Remember, the area is always denoted in centimeter square. So I hope after this sum you have understood how to find the area of a general quadrilateral. I have used the formula which I derived. You can use this formula, or you can find the area of the two triangles separately. Area of triangle PQS is equal to half into QS into PM. You can put the values and find the answer. Then you can find area of triangle RQS, that is half into QS into RN. Find both the area separately, then add them together to get the area of the quadrilateral. Now that is your choice, if you want to use this direct formula or you want to find the area of the triangle separately. Whatever you find convenient, you can easily do it. So I hope this topic is now clear to you. A few more sums of practice will help you understand in detail. Now we move on to the next topic, that is the area of the rhombus. Now for the area of the rhombus, let us first name the rhombus, let us call it L M N O. Now you know in a rhombus the diagonals bisect each other. Let me call this center as P. Now you know the diagonals bisect each other. So which are the diagonals here? First of all, let us identify the diagonals. The diagonals of the rhombus are OM, So this total length OM, let us call it the diagonal 1 or D1. Second rhombus is LN, entire rhombus, let us call it D2. Now, we also know the property that the diagonals bisect each other, means bisect means OP equal to PM. It is indicated OP equal to PM because the diagonal LN cuts OM in two equal parts, OP and PM, and both are equal. Similarly, the diagonal OM, this OM cuts LN into two equal parts as indicated, in two equal parts. Hence we have LP equal to PM. Therefore we can write that OM is equal to 2 into OP. So this whole OM is 2 times OP, and the diagonal LN is 2 times LP. So we can write the whole diagonal LN is 2 times LP. Now, we also know the diagonals of a parallelogram, this rhombus, diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. So because this is a right angle, it means LP is an altitude on OM. This is also a right angle. It means PN is the altitude on OM, and both the altitudes meet at a point P. So if we carry on with the same formula, the area of the rhombus L, M and O, to find the area of the whole rhombus, what we will do, we will take the area of this triangle. Which is this triangle? Area of triangle LOM, this triangle LOM, and add the area of triangle NOM. So area of triangle NOM. Now the area of triangle LOM is equal to half into base into altitude. The base is OM. So I take it as the base OM, and the altitude is LP. So half into OM into LP plus area of triangle NOM is half into base. Base is again OM, into the altitude is PN. So PN. Now, like we did previously, what can be taken out common here? So half comes out common, into OM comes out common, into what remains? LP plus PN. So LP plus PN, right? LP plus PN, that is half into OM into, now we have LP plus PN. What do we have? LP plus PN, that becomes LN. So we get the formula half into OM. What is OM? We took OM as D1, length of diagonal 1, into LN. What is LN? It is D2, length of diagonal 2. So you can now understand, we have made a formula, area of a rhombus is half into length of diagonal 1 into length of diagonal 2. Remember this formula, note it down, write it and learn it. The area of the rhombus is equal to half into length of diagonal 1 into length of diagonal 2. Now let us check out the sum to understand this formula in detail. So we'll try out a sum now. Find the area of the rhombus whose diagonals are of length 10 cm and 8.2 cm. Now let us recall the formula first. Area of rhombus. Can you recall the formula for area of rhombus? We just did previously. It is half into d1 into d2. d1 is length of diagonal 1, d2 is length of diagonal 2. So are the diagonals given to us? Yes, they are. They are 10 cm and 8.2 cm. So just for the sake, I am naming the rhombus ABCD BD. The longer diagonal, I'll call it D1. So this longer diagonal BD, I call D1, and the longer diagonal is of length 10 cm. The shorter diagonal AC, I call it D2, is of the length 8.2 cm. So area of rhombus ABCD is half into D1 into D2, that is half into 10 into 8.2, or I can write half into 10 into 82 upon 10. 10 and 10 I get cut off, 2 ones are 41. So 41 centimeter square is the area of the rhombus ABCD. Now you can see the difference here. Area of a general quadrilateral is found out by cutting the quadrilateral into two triangles and finding the area of the triangle separately. But for the rhombus, we have got a direct formula. Area of rhombus is half into d1 into d2, where d1 is the length of the first diagonal and d2 is the length of the second diagonal. Also remember, area of the parallelogram can be found out by the formula base into altitude. So area of parallelogram, we have a formula for area of a parallelogram, that is base into altitude. Now we have formula for area of the rhombus. Area of rhombus, half into d1 into t2. So one by one we are understanding formulae for different types of quadrilaterals. Now the textbook has got a few sums for us. Find the areas of these quadrilaterals. We are supposed to find out the area of these quadrilaterals. Now we'll try to recall what we have done so far. Try out these three sums, and maybe after doing these three sums, you'll understand what we have done so far. So what I want you to do now is to first pause this video. Stop the video at this moment and try out these sums on your own. And after you have done these sums, you can compare these sums with my solution and see if you have got the right answer. Do not worry about the method. You may have a different method, but we'll compare our answers in the end. So here you need to stop your video or pause your video. Finish these three sums on your own. After finishing these three sums, you can continue the video and then match our solutions. So the first sum we have, what is this shape? This is a shape of a general quadrilateral. Yes? So what is the formula we'll use to find the area of the general quadrilateral? Area of quadrilateral ABCD. Now to find the area of a general quadrilateral, I break it into two triangles. So I know the base AC. So the two triangles I will have is BAC, that is one triangle, and ADC is the other triangle. So I'll write area of triangle ABCD as half into the length of the diagonal which I know AC into sum of the altitudes. So they have not mentioned, I'll call it BM and DN. So I'll write here BM plus DN. Yes, or you can even do the previous method, finding the two triangles separately and then adding the answers. So I have got half into AC, which is given as 6 centimeter, into BM, which is given as 3 centimeter, plus DN, which is given as 5 centimeter. So we have half into 6 into 3 plus 5 is 8. So 2 ones are, 2 threes are, and 8 threes are 24 centimeter square. So if you have got this answer, it means you have understood the topic correctly, and now we can proceed on to the next sum. Now in this next sum, they have not named it, so let us name it. Let us call it A, B, C and D. Now first of all, we try to find out what is this shape. Is it just a general quadrilateral? Is it a parallelogram? Is it a rectangle? Is it a rhombus? Is it a square? So in the previous chapter of quadrilaterals, we had studied the properties of all the quadrilaterals. Now what you can see here is all the four sides are given to be equal. So which is the quadrilateral with all the four sides equal? It can either be a rhombus or a square. But in a square, all the angles are 90 degree, and here the angles are not 90. Because the angles are not 90 and not equal, this is a rhombus. So we have got ABCD is a rhombus. Okay? Now ABCD is a rhombus. So area of rhombus, the formula states area of rhombus is half into D1 into D2. That is half into BD, that is diagonal 1, BD and into AC, the diagonal 2. Okay. Now, what is the confusing part here? The confusing part over here is this 7 BO or is it BD? The book has only mentioned 7. So is the 7 centimeter BO or BD? Now how will you understand what they have given here? But it is very easy to know. How? You can see this. A right angle triangle, right? BOC is a right angle triangle where angle O is a right angle. Now the side opposite to right angle is called the hypotenuse, which should be the longest side. Because 4 is not the longest side, it means this side is not 7, it has to be the whole diagonal BD, which is 7. So we have BD equal to 7 centimeter and AC equal to 6 centimeter. So now we just replace the value. So half into BD, that is 7, into AC is 6. We cut the following, 2 ones are, 2 threes are, and 7 threes are 21. So 21 centimeter square is the area of the rhombus. Let me say it again. I am drawing the triangle for your convenience again. We have got O, B and C. What I was saying here is the diagonals cut at right angles, right? The diagonals cut each other at right angle. So this is a right angle whose measure is 90 degree. Okay? And these two angles are acute angle, means smaller than 90. Because this is the biggest angle, the side opposite to it has to be biggest. So this has to be, if this is 4 centimeter, then the other sides are smaller than 4 centimeter. So this cannot be 7. This cannot be 7. This will be half of 7, that is 3.5. So BD is what is 7 cm. The whole diagonal is 7 cm. So in this sum you have to be very careful. Check out the data, read what is given to us and solve the sum accordingly. But I hope you have understood the formula to find the area of a rhombus. It is half D1 into D2, where D1 is the length of one diagonal and D2 is the length of the other diagonal. In the next sum, what do we have? So you can see here, the opposite sides are equal. So what is the quadrilateral whose opposite sides are equal? It can be a rectangle or it can be a parallelogram. So as you can see, this is a parallelogram. So we'll write the area of the parallelogram ABCD. Now area of the parallelogram is given by the formula base into height. So we can take 5 as the base, but then what will the height be? We have no idea what the height is. So we cannot use this formula. We know a base, but we do not know the height. But we also know that the diagonal cuts a parallelogram into two equal triangles. The diagonal cuts the parallelogram into two equal triangles. One is ABD and the other one is BCD. And both these triangles are equal in area. The diagonal cuts the parallelogram into two equal triangles. So the area of the parallelogram ABCD, area of parallelogram ABCD can be found out by finding area of one triangle, that is A, triangle ABD, and after finding the area we multiply by 2 because both the triangles are equal. So is there a way we can find out the area of triangle ABD? So what is the formula of the area of a triangle? It is half into base, so we'll call this base BD, into altitude, we'll call this altitude AM. And after we find out the whole area, we'll multiply it by 2. So here we can see the 2 and the 2 gets cut off. Right? So what are we left with? BD, that is 8, into AM, that is 2. So 8 2s are 16 centimeter square is the area of this parallelogram ABCD. Why is it a parallelogram? Because the opposite sides are equal. But the formula for the area of the parallelogram is base into altitude. So if we take 5 as the base, we should have one altitude which is not mentioned. Or if we take CD as the base, we should have an altitude which is not mentioned. So here we cannot use the formula base into altitude. But we also know one more property, that a diagonal bisects a parallelogram into two equal parts, means it cuts it into two equal parts. There are two equal triangles. So if we can find the area of one triangle, we can multiply it by 2 and get the area of the whole parallelogram. So this is the sum which is repeated, so we can now neglect that sum. But I hope you will be able to do this on your own. Yes? So if you have not understood, you have got time to rewind the video, see it and do it one more time. So what we can recall now? Yes, let us recall what we have done. Area of parallelogram is base into height or 2 into area of triangle. So you can find one triangle and multiply by 2. Area of quadrilateral, a general quadrilateral, is half into one diagonal into sum of the two altitudes which will be given, h1 and h2. So we can write it half into d into h1 plus h2. I'll draw it here for your reference. A quadrilateral. This is the d. This one is your h1 and this part is your h2. So the area of this quadrilateral is half into the diagonal d into the height h1 plus the height h2. Area of rhombus is equal to half into d1 into d2. That is half into this whole diagonal is d1 into diagonal this is d2. And what we did previously is area of the trapezium is equal to h by 2 l1 plus l2. So what is this? L1 and L2. L1 is the length of one parallel side, L2 is the length of the second parallel side, and H is the height between the two parallel sides, also called the altitude. So area of trapezium is H by 2 L1 plus L2. You can rewind the video and see it one more time. Understand these four formulae because I have left you something in the homework. The homework consists of exercise 11.2, sum number 1 to 8 on page number 177 and 178. The solutions of the sums I will present in the next video where you can compare your answers with mine. But first of all, you need to understand the four different shapes, the quadrilateral, the general quadrilateral, the parallelogram, the rhombus and the trapezium. The square and the rectangle, the formula for the area of the square and the rectangle we already know. So four more have been added to the family, quadrilateral family. Do it thoroughly and solve the sums. I am going to end here. Thank you.